Today we're going through riffs from five of the greatest blues guitarists of all time. Before we get into that, though, I want to talk a little bit about rhythm, because rhythm is imperative to having great phrasing in blues music. And so I've drawn up a little chart here. I'm going to show it to you right now, and hopefully this will help you understand timing a little bit more. Okay, so we've got a 12-8 time signature here, and 12-8 means 12 eighth notes worth of music. Each one of these is an eighth note, so I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 12 of them. If we were going to time that out and just do each note, the rhythm would be 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, like that. Now we can also take these triplets and subdivide them further. I've divided each one into two down here. So instead of going 1, 2, 3, I go 1 and 2 and 3 and. So understanding this division is very important in blues music, because a lot of times guitarists will start, say, here on the second half of beat two of the triplet. So it'd be like 1, 2, and. So 1 and 2 and 3 and. Or they might start over here on the second half of beat three of the triplet. So 1 and 2 and 3 and. If you understand that division, you're going to be able to hear what the blues phrasing is much easier, because that sort of thing is happening all the time in a lot of blues music. So I've written down a riff here that kind of demonstrates a bit of that. I've got what's called it's a quarter note, and then these two are sixteenths. This quarter note is worth 2 eighth notes. 2 sixteenths are worth 1 eighth note. So 1, 2, 3. So if I was going to play that, I'd count it 1, 2, 3, and like that. Then I have another one here that is the mirror image of that, basically. It's 2 sixteenths and a quarter, so that'd be 1 and 2, 3, 1 and 2, 3, like that. So anyway, I hope this little primer kind of helps you understand rhythms in blues music better. If that's totally over your head, then you need to go back and learn some basics before you get to this. But understanding this will help you create blues licks much better. It'll help you be able to understand what other guitarists are playing on blues records. So I hope that helps. But let's get to the lesson right now. Okay, this is a B.B. King riff, so I'm going to count through it really slowly for you. Learning to count this would be really, really good for you to get this down, to really understand this phrasing. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 1 and 2 and 3 and 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 1 and 2 and 3 and. So in that lick, B.B. King is using some really interesting phrasing. He's playing within the triplets, using those second halves of the triplet. So 1 and 2 and 3 and, like that kind of idea. So practice on that, speed that up, and add that B.B. King lick to your repertoire. So for this Albert King lick, it's got some sneaky phrasing and some great bending as well. I'll run through it really slowly for you and we'll talk about it. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1 and 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1 and 2, 3. 1, 2, and 3. So really interesting, that bending that happens in that. Really have to dig in and just really push and get that thumb over the neck to kind of help you with that for stability. And you also want the other fingers, the middle and the index, to help that ring finger. That'll really help you get that bend. But really count that, like count through that really slowly like we did. If you count through that, and speed it up and gradually get it faster and faster, you really understand that kind of phrasing that Albert King is using there. Freddie King does some interesting stuff on this riff. chromaticism. The hardest thing about this lick is basically getting the speed for the picking. And I would just play that alternate picking the whole thing. This lick actually sounds great playing it over the 4 chord in the key of A, so I'd play that over a D7 chord. It sounds pretty good that way. This Hubert Sumlin lick is a very classic lick. It's like a blues cliche, I guess, at this point. And it's been used on so many recordings. Nothing really too difficult about it. It has a nice sort of a vibe with the triplets there. I'll run through it for you really slowly, just using the blues scale in A. For this Buddy Guy lick, I'd recommend playing it over the 4 chord in the key of A, so that's a D7 chord. So when you're approaching D7, you're going to start on the last 8th note of the A chord. So that'd be after 4 bars of A, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, and then the next bar is going to D7. We'll pretend that we're playing this over top of the D7, I'm going to count it out for you now. It's got some interesting rhythm. I'd recommend counting along, trying to get this phrasing, really important with the phrasing. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. And nothing too crazy happening with the scale there, just using a basic blues scale. That note there is from the major blues scale. But you can take that and move that around. If you understand that whatever key you're in, you know, if I was going to do that in the key of E, I might go like this. I hope you've enjoyed delving into a little blues stuff with me today. It's always fun to take these licks and use them and get them in your playing, and they work in a lot of different places. Listen to the Let's Dance album by David Bowie, perfect example. Stevie Ray Vaughan taking all the Albert King licks and playing them all over a pop record. So, yeah, have fun with that, and I will see you soon.